Yes.
Okay, my team says yes. Okay, cool. Okay, so very welcome to our second keynote, Symbio Employee Assistant, how apps ensure work in compliance. I will guide you, yeah, in the next 20 minutes to our new approach, regarding employee assistant apps. After a short introduction, we will introduce you to the motivation behind the development of our first app, the Training Assistant app. In a live demo today, you can see a first early version of our Training Assistant. Afterwards, I will present you with the basic ideas of our employee assistant apps, which we can then discuss in detail in the workshop. So, together with Steffen, I will do this presentation, but also Steffen has some technical problems with our live events. It's new for us, and Setter is a Google company, so it's not so easy to join here with the Microsoft tool. But he try to do this in the next minutes, so maybe he can join us in 10 minutes maybe. So nevertheless, I would thank Steffen. He's the head of process management at Setter. And I hope he can explain later on the situation, et cetera, and the related motivation for the development of the training assistant, and can give us an overview what the motivation for the development of the training assistant was. So my name is Elmar Kubata. I'm the product owner or one of the product owners of Symbio. Together with Setter, I'm responsible for the development of the training assistant. So I think right now he's not joining. So I will jump over the slides of Setter and we will come back hopeful in a few minutes to the slides to explain what are the situation today at Setter, why we develop the training assistant. But nevertheless, I summarized the requirements from Setter, and so on. We can start with that. So in the end, the requirements, the main requirement was that the training assistant ensure that your employees do not work out of compliance. So that's a big thing for a company like Setter. It's an Airbus company. I think you know this, and they have big requirements to this audit process or to this compliance things and so on. We had this big requirement that every employee should work all the time compliant. So, and on the other hand, this should be stored in an audit-proof storage. So it's clear if you are working for Air Force or like this, you have big processes and big audits, and so we should do this, and I will explain later on how we resolve that. And also and a manager have a clear overview of all his employees, so that he knows if one of his employees work out of compliance. That's also an important point to know this. And here we also consider the requirements of work councils, especially in Germany. That's a big point. So it's clear maybe this app we will later show you, work in different companies a little bit differ. So, and the last point, or in conclusion, that is one of the biggest points in the end, we have placed special focus on the usability and the reduced scope of functions in order to support the employees as efficient as possible in his everyday life. So that is even, and we will later see this, one of the biggest requirements or one of the biggest points why we develop this new app world, let me say it like this. Okay, but we start now to go a little bit, dive deeper, let me say it like this, to the training assistant. As I said, that is one of our first real development of an app like this. And you know Symbio, where you store all your processes. And when you release a new process or a document, we generate training tasks. And this training tasks are generated based on the roles used in the processes and documents. And for every role in the end, we know the positions. From this relationship, we identify the individual user. So in the end, every user each user has his own overview of training tasks, including the due date. So if you, maybe in holiday or you don't see your tasks, the task will be red. And if you reach your due day in a few days, it will be yellow. And so, you can see all the time what are your tasks you have to do. And you have three different, ways to work on a training. So the easiest way is clear. You can confirm the training and you confirm the training in time, then everything is fine. The second point is you confirm the training not in time, then this training assistant app asks you, did you work out of compliance? Maybe if you was in holiday, it's not a problem. So you can say, no, I don't work out of compliance. I was on holiday or whatever. But if you click yes, we store it in the database. And the manager knows that you worked for a time out of compliance. And the third point is clear, you can also reject trainings. Maybe if you don't understand the process or it was a wrong assignment or something else, then you can also reject it. So, and as I said, there was also a requirement that a manager see all the trainings of all his employees. So we have also a clear overview of all members of a team, but that is easier to show you in the live demo. So right now, let me show you a very first look to our actual implementation of our training assistant. And as I said, I will start in Symbio. So I think most of you know Symbio, so I will not spend so many time here in our core application to explain how Symbio works. So if you're not familiar with our core application, please join one of our webinars or ask our sales guys to give you a clear presentation what the core system is and how you can use it. But nevertheless, as we see here, a process with two different roles, a buyer and a purchase manager, and both of them have related positions, and these positions are related to users. So for example, the purchase manager is directly related to my user. I can shortly show it to you. So that is why I am later on receive a training here. Yeah, so you see here purchase manager, the purchase manager is related to my name here, and it is related to the role. It is also called purchase manager. And for example, here this procurement buyer is another position. It's related to another colleague of me. It's Niels, and yeah, he is related to this role buyer. So if we jump back to the process and release it shortly, I can also make a short change here. For example, I change the name so that we see later on what happens in the training assistant. So I release it, and I'm in the end the responsible of the process. And so I can fasten up the release cycle. That is easier here for the testing. And yeah, now the process is released. You see it here in, yeah, in the version 2.0. And okay, it was maybe a little bit fast. You can also maintain the start of validity. Yeah, as I don't change this value, it is automatically set to 2 weeks ago. But you can change it, or it's more or less, yeah, two months, I think. Sorry, 2 weeks. Yeah, it's the 9th of July. So that due date in the end, we will later see in the training assistant, because that is the time you have to fulfill your training. So when we jump over to the training assistant, yeah, you see a very clear and easy to use interface. So I only see my trainings here in a very nice and reduced overview. I see my states here, so I don't have start any of these trainings. And yeah, right now you see, oh, here come a fourth training. That is what this training I released a couple seconds before. You already mentioned maybe that it is not necessary to refresh the page or something like this. We use here the newest technology, let me say it like this, and every things or every refreshes from the backend comes automatically to the users. So I can now click this training, and now it will load the data from the course system. You see also, or you see here also a very reduced, process view. It's not finished. Yeah, it's clear. The whole application is not finished. We are still working to responsive design, and we are not finished here with all details like typo and for example, here the info column is empty. But I think you will understand the idea. It's a very easy and reduced process view. Nevertheless, you can jump to the business manager and can jump to the process here and see the full process. But we will definitely extend this view here, and in future it's not necessary to jump back to the other application. You can easily jump to the next training here, but in the end, if you understood the training or the process changes, you can confirm it here, And yeah, a small dialogue will open. You can add your email address here. We will change it later on, but then the training is finished. So you will also see now, that training is now in process because I opened the training here. And you see also in your training history, which trainings are, for example, done in the past from my person here. You have a clear overview in the end, which are the next trainings you should do, sorted by the due date. And the last thing here is the training dashboard. As you see here, I have actually only one member here in my training or my demo environment, and you see Niels has no overdue trainings and one training in the state to do, so everything is okay. It's not necessary to call him that he should do his trainings. Okay, it works also for documents. It's similar to the processes. It's clear, and it's clear it's not the end, so we will extend this application, and later on it's clear we will also discuss with you what are your ideas and your requirements to NAP like the training assistant. Okay, so
thanks for
I jump over.
There's actually a few questions popping in. The first one is the confirmation is just a click, or will it verify that the person has example viewed a training video?
Once again.
The confirmation is just a click, or will it verify that the person has example viewed a training video?
We can combine it. It's clear. Right now, it's only in click. And as I said, we will definitely enhance this functionality. And but for now, it's a click. But if the due date is over, you must additionally confirm that, you're not work out of compliance.
Okay. And then, are there any Symbio users that use the Symbio Training Assistant in combination with success factors, like success factors learning module?
Right now, it's completely new, so it was the very first presentation of the training assistant, even Setter. We developed together with Setter this training assistant. Are currently not work with this training assistant. It needs some more, let me say, weeks or months for the first go live, and everyone can join the party and can join our new apps, and especially also the training assistant. That's clear. And it's clear we can also do interfaces to tools like SuccessFactor, no problem.
And then one last question, would a general training on all processes to all employees be available? I mean, without a direct connection to the role.
The short answer is yes. Yes, we are flexible, let me say, how we make the, let me say, the connection between the, the users and the process. Here in this example, I showed you that we have the relationship between roles and positions, and from the position you know the employees, but there are other ways to collect in the end trainings to your employees. So we are flexible how we do this.
Okay. So thank you, and we're actually a bit over time, so I would like you to ask to move to the meetings room again so we can start the workshop up there. Julia is already waiting for us. I will post the link to the meetings room again, and also to the whiteboard, so that you will be able to also work actively.
Okay, so Yeah, if we don't have more time, give me short short introduction. I have some other slides, but no matter. Mm-hmm. But to start the workshop, let me give you a little bit. Let me say some words to the general idea of our employee assistant apps. So in future, we will not stop here with the training assistant, and the aim of the employee apps is to bring more interactivity into the daily work of the individual employee. So we use the large database from process management and combine it with active work items from everyday business. So that is in the end our idea. As you already explained in your introduction, we have the map in behind, and now we want to use this data in the real life. Yeah. So, and I will give you maybe some ideas. It's only a handful of ideas what could be the next step. It's maybe also, in the end, a good start for our workshop. We will start in a couple of seconds. So, for example, we can do a process, my process world app. Yeah, so focused on construction site workers, for example, or we can do like action apps where Zoombio combine all tasks and bring them into employees' everyday business. Yeah, or other ideas like we do, for example, the risk manager to mitigate risks and prove that controls associated and tests are carried out. And last, so I jump or go a little bit faster so that we don't run out of time, is for example the audit manager, which will support you by doing audits. So there are four ideas. I think you have much more ideas. You have also the possibility to register to this beta program of our first app. So you can copy this link. You can give us a first feedback and can register here for our beta program. We will also share this link later on. So if you are not fast enough, do it later.